Of canals, and right now the city is taking preventative measures to make sure those canals don't overflow and get into your home. You can see crews lowering weirs throughout the city today. NBC2's Jennifer Vaglis is looking at the preparations.
Driving around areas like Leeson Parkway, Chiquita Boulevard, or here, Bernstorr Road today, you may notice the weirs are a little more active than normal. That's because city crews lowered them to keep freshwater canal levels low ahead of any storm surge Ian could bring.
We're ready for whatever comes.
That's a goal for Cape Coral city leaders. Not letting a moment go to waste, prepping for the heavy rainfall, strong winds, and storm surge Ian could bring. Today, starting with the city's 400-mile canal system. It plays a big role when it comes to storms.
That canal system is the primary drainage conveyance for the city.
The system built to withstand the kind of rainfall we see almost every afternoon this time of year. But
if we end up with, 3-4 inches of rain in an hour in an isolated area, I mean, that will overtake our system's ability to drain.
Something Lou Kirk saw after storms like Charlie and Irma.
Our canal kind of tilts this way to that side, so we were fortunate.
His neighbor's backyard across the canal, not so much.
Underwater for a day or two till the water went down, the storm surge went down, the storm passed.
That's why today, crews lowered the city's weirs, making more room in freshwater canals for stormwater. Meanwhile, the city also cleaned up project sites, picking up barricades and cones before the storm's heavy winds do.
There's always apprehension, always, hope for the best, expect the worst kind of thing.
The county oversees the city's one and only hurricane shelter at Island Coast High School. Right now, the county says it has no plans to open it, but if that changes, you can count on NBC2 to let you know. I'm in Cape Coral, Jennifer Vaglis, NBC2.